ये जो इंडिया है ना, यहां अगर रशीद और पिंकी ने की है शादी तो यूपी पुलिस क्यों बनी है कबाब में हड्डी? यस, द हरासमेंट हैज स्टार्टेड. रशीद एंड पिंकी गॉट मैरिड इन जुलाई, वेंट टू गेट देयर मैरिज रजिस्टर्ड इन मुरादाबाद लास्ट वीक लाइक लैक्स ऑफ इंडियन कपल्स. बट इंस्टेड ऑफ इट बीइंग द हैप्पीएस्ट डे ऑफ देयर लाइव्स, इट एंडेड विद रशीद एंड हिज ब्रदर इन अ यूपी पुलिस जेल एंड पिंकी इन अ वुमेन्स शेल्टर होम. व्हाई? Because of UP's bigoted, divisive, unconstitutional anti-love jihad ordinance. It took Pinky 2 days to convince the district magistrate that she was an adult who had chosen to marry Rashid. Only then could she return to her in-laws, while Rashid is still stuck in jail. Bareilly, Kushinagar, Mau, Lucknow, Sitapur, stories of harassment, intimidation and abuse are being reported across UP. And if this hate-filled experiment works, 4 more BJP-ruled states plan to follow. So before that happens, we need to understand how the idea of love jihad is fake, how cleverly this simple but sinister term is being sold to us, and also why this crass concept of love jihad is so important to those who practice communal politics in India. This video went viral in October. The claim that this was a Hindu father begging his daughter not to marry a Muslim man, calling it a case of love jihad. Right-wing commentator Shefali Vaidya shared it on Facebook saying, "This video broke my heart. Hindu father begging his daughter not to fall prey to love jihad. She will end up as a third wife bearing her 5th child, or she will end up being beheaded." A tweet by Rini Lin sharing the video had thousands of likes and retweets and said, "Another Hindu daughter deceived in Islam marriage. She will regret it because right after marriage, she will be killed." But you know what? The quint found out that the husband was not Muslim. The couple's names were Lakharam and Sita, both Hindu from Rajasthan. Yes, the girl's father did not want Sita to marry Lakharam, but no Hindu-Muslim aspect to the story at all. Yet, this is how lies about so-called love jihad is spread, with the specific intent of shredding the secular fabric of our country into bits. Now, we work overtime calling out such fake videos, but each time, by the time we do that, it's been seen and shared by thousands, and some end up believing what they've been told. And that's how the big lie about love jihad stays alive. And there are many bigots creating more such fake videos. So even as one gets debunked, new ones start getting shared. Now, built around this fake idea of love jihad is an intimidation and protection industry as well. People and groups who say to us कि ये जो खतरनाक चीज है लव जिहाद दैट एक्चुअली डजंट एग्जिस्ट, वी विल फाइट इट फॉर यू, वी विल प्रोटेक्ट यू फ्रॉम इट. दिस इज हाउ लव जिहाद इज यूज टू स्मियर द एंटायर मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी. मीट विकास चौहान एंड स्वामी जितेंद्रानंद सरस्वती. इन आर गली मोहल्लास, इन आर विलेजेस, ऑन व्हाट्सएप, दीज आर द पीपल यू विल फाइंड पेडलिंग लाइज, हेट एंड वायलेंस अगेंस्ट लव जिहाद. It is crucial to understand how their mind works, how they operate. ये बात सुनिए.
वो तो हमारी बहन बेटियों को भी मार दें और हम वायलेंस भी ना करें.
निकिता अंतिम बिटिया है जो बलिदान हुई इस लव जिहाद की बलिवेदी पर, और कल से जो तूफान देश में खड़ा होगा आंदोलन का, उसकी जांच, उसकी तपिस कोई सरकार हो.
My colleague Asmita Nandi met them outside the home of Nikita Tomar, who was shot dead in October 2020 by a man who had stalked her for over 2 years. Since the man was Muslim and Nikita was Hindu, it was twisted into a case of love jihad. In front of the girl's house, they lied about the facts of the case.
ये जिहाद इसलिए हुआ कि उस लड़की से पहले मिला जाता है हिंदू नाम से.
हाँ, ये लड़का भी हिंदू नाम से मिला
जाता है, हिंदू के नाम से. जब वो बच्ची फंस जाती है तब अंत में उसको पता चलता है कि ये मुस्लिम है, इसलिए ये जिहाद हुआ।
But Nikita's father told us the accused had never approached Nikita with a Hindu name।
जैसे न्यूज़ में एक आया था कि राहुल नाम बता रहा था उसने, ऐसा तो कुछ मैंने सुना नहीं है मैडम।
अच्छा
मैडम, लव जिहाद तो मैं जानता ही नहीं क्या होता है।
The fact is Nikita's family had been dealing with this stalker who is an entitled male brat from a politically connected family। The crime here that needs to be tackled is stalking। Stalker attacks girl with acid, stalker shoots girl dead। In most such cases the stalker and victim are from the same community, not Hindu Muslim। Child marriages, honor killings, marital rape, shouldn't our police and legal system focus on that? And don't we already have laws for that? Shouldn't we actually be encouraging intercaste and interfaith marriages instead of fighting an imaginary thing called love jihad? But let's return to Swami Jitendranand outside Nikita Tomar's house and see how he openly incites violence।
उत्तर प्रदेश में तो जिस तरीके से हमने गोली मारना शुरू किया है ना, गाड़ी पलटना शुरू किया है ना, उत्तर प्रदेश में योगी पर तो हमें विश्वास है पूरा, हम तो हैं निपटाल। लेकिन इस हरियाणा के विशेषकर मेवात में जो आतंक इनका है, इस आतंक को खत्म करने के लिए एक बार अपने मन से आप भय निकालिए, हम वकील देंगे आपको, कुछ होता है जमानत हम कराएंगे।
We know how to palto vehicles, says Jitendranand, a clear reference to the Vikas Dubey fake encounter in UP, a direct signal to the public gathered around that when it comes to love jihad, the political leadership and local administration, be it in Haryana or UP, is on his side. It is now out in the open that hate mongerers like Jitendranand have the formal backing of elected state governments. Yet petitions have been filed in the Supreme Court and many believe the ordinance will be struck down as unconstitutional for several reasons. Firstly, despite the irresponsible use of the term love jihad by 5 chief ministers so far, the fact is that the central government, the country's police forces, don't yet record offences under the heading of love jihad. Secondly, there are already laws against forced conversion. Third, any law that declares that religious conversion of a consenting adult for marriage is illegal will violate the Constitution's fundamental commitment to secularism in India. But here's my point. I don't really believe these state governments will be too disappointed if their proposed anti-love jihad laws are struck down several months from now. Because for such a law to come through would be an unlikely bonus. What the real objective is for love jihad to be talked about, to exist in political speeches, to continue to be spread as fake news on social media, to be thrashed about in TV newsrooms of Godi media. And that is more than enough to keep tarring, to keep vilifying India's entire Muslim population. And finally, understand this, labeling an entire community as terrorist is not easy. क्योंकि इवन अ बिगट नोज दैट हथियार उठाना किसी मामूली इंसान के लिए इतना भी आसान नहीं है। बट द एक्ट ऑफ फॉलिंग इन लव, दैट मोस्ट नेचुरल वंडरफुल ह्यूमन एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ फॉलिंग इन लव, कन्वर्टिंग दैट इनटू अ डीवियस एक्ट ऑफ कंस्पिरेसी एंड लेबलिंग इट एज लव जिहाद, दैट मेक्स इट फार सिंपलर फॉर इंडियाज हेट ब्रिगेड टू टार एन एंटायर कम्युनिटी, फार ईजियर देन अक्यूजिंग देम ऑफ बींग टेररिस्ट। And it doesn't need proving in a court of law. It just needs to be believed by millions of people. Ye jo India hai na, ultimately no law court can demolish the idea of love jihad. It has to be rejected and trashed in the mind and heart of every secular Indian.